Welcome to our lecture online. Now that we've found the diagonal elements of the inertia tensor, we're now ready to find the off-diagonal elements. Again, what we're trying to do here is find the inertia tensor of 1/8 of a unit sphere that's located in the positive quadrant with a density equal to 1, just to make things easy. And for the same reason that we had symmetry and got the same value for all diagonal elements, we have a symmetry so that we'll find the same value for all the off-diagonal elements. Whatever we find for the ixy, which of course is equal to the iyx, we should find for the ixz and for the iyz as well. So let's start with the general formula that we take the density times a negative 1 times x times y times dv, and we're going to integrate over that volume. Realizing when we change from Cartesian coordinates to spherical coordinates that x can be expressed like this and y can be expressed like this. That means when we multiply x times y together, we pull the negative 1 out and the density is equal to 1. We end up with the negative 1 in front, r squared sine square of theta sine of phi cosine of phi when we multiply x times y together. And the volume element dv is r squared sine of theta dr d theta d phi. So when we multiply these together, we end up with an r to the fourth, sine cube of theta, sine of phi, cosine of phi, dr d theta d phi. And the limits of integration are from 0 to 1, from 0 to pi over 2, and from 0 to pi over 2. We're going to start with the d phi. Here we have a sine and a cosine, and I know that the differential or the derivative of the sine is the cosine of phi times d phi. So that means if u is equal to the sine of phi, then du will be the cosine of phi times d phi. So when we integrate, we get sine square over 2, which is what we have over here. And the cosine of phi, d phi, they drop off. The limits from 0 to pi over 2. When we plug in the lower limit, we get 0. Plug in the upper limit, we get 1 over 2. Put that in the front, we end up with a plus 1/2. Why do we end up with a plus 1/2? Well, first we end up with a minus 1/2, so let's plug in the minus. But then, when we integrate the following, the sine cube of theta, that is equal to the minus of 1/3 the cosine of theta times the sine square of theta plus 2. So the minus from here goes over here and makes that into a plus. So now when we integrate that, we have the limits from 0 to pi over 2. When we plug in the upper limit, the cosine of pi over 2 is equal to 0, so this whole thing goes to 0. Plug in the lower limit, 1/3 of the cosine of 0, that's the cosine of 0, that would be 1. And the sine of 0, of course, is 0, but we have a plus 2 there. So we have a 2 times a minus 1, because we're subtracting, because we plug in the lower limit, times a third, that's minus 2/3 is the result of that. We have a minus 1/2 in the front. Well, actually, that became a plus 1/2, so let's make that a plus now. But when we multiply the 2/3 times 1/2, that gives us a minus 1/3 again in the front. And now we're ready to integrate r to the 4th dr. That becomes r to the 5th over 5. The limits are from 0 to 1. We have minus 1 over 15 times 1. And so we end up with minus 1 over 15, which means that all the off-diagonal elements are going to be minus 1 over 15. So minus 1 over 15. Minus 1 over 15, minus 1 over 15, and minus 1 over 15, like that. So essentially, then of course, if you want to factor out a 1 over 15, we get I is equal to 1 over 15, and then the elements become pi along the diagonal, and minus 1 in the off, like that. And that will now be the inertia tensor for a 1/8 sphere located in the positive quadrant with density equal to 1. So there's a very nice example of how to find the inertia tensor of a volume or a mass distribution. The integrals can get quite complicated, so at least this is doable, and that's a good example for you to see how to go about solving a problem like this. And hopefully that'll give you a better idea what a tensor is and why we need them in the first place. And you can see that this is a very good example of why tensors are needed.